Hello and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can copy documents from SharePoint document library into Azure Blob storage. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. You may want to archive documents stored in a SharePoint document library after a period, or you want to keep a backup of documents securely in case someone deleted from the SharePoint document library. These are few of many use cases for storing documents to Azure Blob storage from SharePoint document library. So without further ado, let's get started and see how it works. I'm inside Office 365. So from the app launcher, if I go to SharePoint and if I search for sales team site, I have sales team site, I can click on it. And on this side, if I go to site content, there is a document library contracts. So the idea is whenever I upload a document into this contracts library, it automatically takes a copy of this document and store it to Azure Blob storage. First, we need to set up the Azure storage with a container so we can store our files there. And then we'll create a Power Automate flow to copy the file from SharePoint document library to Azure container. If I navigate to a new browser, and if I type portal.azure.com, if you're not already logged in, it will ask you to log into your Office 365 account. So I can see I have already logged into my account here. So if you already have a subscription, you can work from it. And if you don't have a subscription, you have to sign up to the Azure subscription. There are different subscriptions available. But hopefully if you're working for a company and they already have Azure environment up and running, it will have subscription. It will be just you need to be added into that subscription so you can create resource group and storage accounts, etc. So the first thing first, we need to create a resource group. If I start typing resource, I can see the resource group here. I will click on it and I will click on create. Now, first thing first, we need to select which subscription we need to create this resource group under. So I only got one subscription. The resource group name, I'm just calling it SharePoint Files Group. And region, I will just keep it default. I don't have to do anything extra, tags or other things. I will just click on review and create. So the validation is passed. I can now click on create. Okay, so the resource group is created. Now if I go back to the home page, the next thing we need to create is we need to create a storage account. I can see that option here as well. But if you haven't used in the past, you won't see that option here. So you have to search for it. So if I say storage, so if I start typing storage, you can see the storage account option here. So I will click on it. Okay, so I don't have any storage account at the moment. I can click on plus sign to create a storage account. Okay, so I will keep that default subscription and the resource group. We just created that resource group. So we'll select that resource group. The storage account name. Okay, so I'll just call it SharePoint contracts. Okay. So that is available. Now I will click on go next. I don't need to change anything here. Go next. Nothing needs to be changed here. Go next. Next. And then blobs and file only. So we only interested to save files, not any tables or any list from SharePoint. So that's why we're just selecting the blobs and files only. Click on next. Nothing needs to be changed here. Next. And now it is doing the final checks and validation. So validations are passed. I can click on create. Now my storage contract account is created. So the deployment at the moment is in progress. It takes roughly around a minute or so to get it fully deployed. So now you can see that it's all been deployed. I can click on go to resource. Now you can see there is a storage account with this name created. Now the next thing we need to do is we need to add a data storage container where we can save our file. So if I click on containers, and by default there is a log container available, so I can click on this plus sign and create a new container. So I'll call it SP contracts. So the SharePoint contracts access level. So for now, I'll just keep it private. I'll click on create. So now we have created a container, SP contracts container, where we will save all the contract documents from the SharePoint to Azure Blob storage. So when we'll create a Power Automate flow, we will need a couple of things from this Azure Storage. So first thing, we need the access key. So if I click on access key, I need the storage account name, which is this one, and the key. So the keys are not appearing right now, so I can click on show key. So the key will appear. I can then just copy it to the clipboard and then paste it in the flow. But let's leave it like this. I will come back to it. If I go to office365.com and click on this app launcher and go to Power Automate. So before I go and create a workflow manually, let's see if there is a template available. So if I go on templates and let me type something here, copy files to Azure, let me search. So yeah, copy files from a SharePoint folder to Azure blob folder. This is what we're looking for. I will select this. It will ask me to create a connection to the SharePoint, which is I'm already logged into Office 365. So it has established that connection and my permission on the SharePoint. Now is asking me to fix the connection issue to Azure blob storage. So I will click on fix connection. Here I need to provide a connection name. I will just call it SP blob. And then we need Azure storage account name and Azure storage account access key. So if I go back to Azure storage, so SharePoint contracts was our Azure storage account. And then this is the account name. I will copy that, paste it here. And then this is our key. So I will copy that to my clipboard and paste it here as well and click on update. So this will establish the connection between Power Automate and the Azure blob store. I will click on continue. The Azure blob storage is a premium connector. So if you're not using premium version of Power Automate, you need to sign up for a trial or buy a premium license so that you can use this create file premium action of Azure. So it is asking me when a file is created, which site address. So we know it's a sales team site. So I will select the sales team site. So it is sales team. And the folder we know is a document library called contracts. So I will select the document library called contracts. Okay, so the folder path where we want to store these files once they are moved to Azure. So I will select on this folder. So if I go back to containers, we have created a container called SP contract. This container is kind of a folder structure within the Azure blob store. So if I go back to Power Automate, we only got one folder here, one container. So we can select the folder path. So the blob name is going to be whatever the name of that file, and blob content is going to be whatever the content of that file. So I will click on save. Our workflow is ready. So whenever we create a new file in SharePoint, it is going to copy that file into this Azure blob storage. Your workflow could be like something you run every day or every month and look for any files which are not been modified for, let's say, last 1 year or 5 years, move those files or copy those files into Azure storage. So you can use this concept in many different implementation wherever you want to have a communication between SharePoint document library and Azure blob storage. So I will click on save. Okay, so our workflow is ready. If I go back to the Azure blob storage and if I click on SP contracts container, this container is empty. I can upload a file here if I, so let's test it now. So if I go to sales team contracts document library in SharePoint and if I click on upload and I will click on files, let's upload a temporary file. There is a customer sample data. So I will click on this. It's an Excel file and I'll click on open. So as soon as the files get uploaded into the SharePoint document library, it will kickstart the Power Automate flow, which will take a copy of this file and store it to the Azure blob store. If I go back to the previous page where I can see the workflow history. Okay, so the flow ran successfully. It only took 2 milliseconds. All it's doing is taking the file and creating a copy of the same document into Azure blob storage. So if I navigate back to Azure container and if I just refresh this page, or I can click on refresh here, I can see a customer Excel file is copied here. If I click on it, I can see the detail of that file, when it was created, and I can download the file as well. So if I click on download, the files get downloaded, and if I click on it, I can actually open the file and see the contents. So to just wrap up this video, today you have learned how easily you can copy documents from SharePoint document library into an Azure blob container using Power Automate Flow. Thank you for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you are new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any question regarding this topic or any other query related to Microsoft 365, put in the comment section below. I review the comments on a daily basis. I will be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.